This is my first proper with commentary F1 video today. I haven't long got the game. I'm yet to do a full career, so I thought I would do a career today with a bit of commentary and just fill you guys in about the game. So far, so good. The game is brilliant. The graphics, they're in a league of their own. The in general, the cars, you can now upgrade your cars, and it does make a difference. Where before you would update your car and you wouldn't really feel or see any difference in the car at all. Now, I think it's RDA. You go into this, you change settings of the car. It actually does work. I find the understeering, the oversteering, the brakes, the engine performance, everything. So here we go. So we're going to go into career mode. You've got career, you've got pro career. I think the difference between the two of them, is in pro career you go straight to a big team, and also it's 100% race. So every race is 100%. So it's going to be the full lap. So it's going to be, 50 odd, 57, 58 laps. Which, on TV, it's not much with the controller in your hand. To do 100% every single race is really a bit too much. So I'm going to go with the standard career mode. I'm going to st oh, it showed I did have a career. Okay, so I'll delete that career because I've obviously done that by accident, just messing around. So I'm going to start a new career. I usually do maybe just a short weekend. Or I could custom it. So if I go custom and I'm going to go medium because I'm not going to do a very easy. Hard, I don't think I'm going to be good enough to compete yet. So I'm going to go medium just to see how that works out. Helmet, there's quite a good choice of helmet as well compared to the helmets of last game. I think the choices on here are you have a few more, and obviously you can unlock more helmets as you progress. So I think you may be able to unlock Lewis Hamilton's helmet, Nico Rosberg. So at some point, I think you can have your idols. Helmets. So if you're a Lewis Hamilton fan, you can have his helmet with your number on and your name on, etc. I think you can do that. I'm not 100% sure yet, but we'll look into that obviously the further I can manage to get. So let's try and find a helmet. I quite like the look of that one. And this one. I'll try this. Let's see what this one is. You can obviously go up here and down here, change the colouring of it. So obviously the red there has got really red. So I'm going to go with red, quite bright, because I'm a Bristol City fan. So naturally they're red. So I'm going to go with them. Then you go down to saturation, and then you can again change. And that got quite a chrome effect. So I'm going to go with that. And then you can really go down dark. That stands right out. You can go back. You can go bright. Oh, I'm gonna go with that. Yeah, that's quite cool. It's like a chrome effect. I like that. Right, there you go. Obviously, you choose your nation. So for me, it is United Kingdom. So I'm British. Obviously, whichever nationality you are, there's absolutely loads to choose from. So you can come here. Not quite sure why they've got an Irish flag when that goes in with United Kingdom, but oh, they have got English flag. Okay, brilliant. Okay, I'm going to choose that one. I thought you could only be British flag. My driver number, I'm a Lewis Hamilton fan, so I'm going to go with 45 because I'm a number away from him. My name is Craig. My surname is May. Abbreviated name will be May, just like in the races they show Lewis Hamilton's name is Ham, don't name but. So mine's gonna be May. So I have a great short, I have a great surname because there's only three letters anyway, Craig May. Abbreviated name, you need three letters, so I've got a perfect name for that. Right, so team, selecting team. Now you could go for a big team, one of the top four straight away, but it's, I find it's not as much fun. If you start from the bottom, one of these three, at least you can work your way up to maybe this level, because I think if you win races or get on the podium with these four here will offer you a contract, and then from there one of these big guns should then offer you a contract, unless you're really good in one of these bottom three, then the top will offer you a contract straight away, like maybe Williams or Red Bull. Mercedes, Ferrari, very hard to get a contract offer from them. So I would go, I'm going to go Manor Racing. I'm going to pick Berline. And I'm going to start my career. Race settings. Bus brakes on. Frequent damage reduced. Safety car on. Corner cutting strategy regular. Formation lap on. Starts assisted. Assists. Driving. Proximity custom. Braking assist off. Anti lock brakes on. Traction control full. Dynamic racing line full. 3D. Gearbox on my pits. Yes. This is whatever. Tire allocation, so six. I usually go with the end one because that's not giving you any mediums or softs. It's giving you more super softs. And that again, I usually go with sort of 5-4-4, stuff like that, because it's, you've got a similar amount of each tyre then. You don't really want like seven of them and only three of the every, in case the super softs don't come into play. You need mediums or softs. Then you've got five sets of super softs just doing nothing. And if it's a long race, you can easily wear your tyres down and not have enough. So I'm going to go with that one. I'm going to do a 25% race because 50 and 100% is just too much. On your old thumbs and hands, etc. I'm going to do a one-shot qualifying. Full practice. Start session. Start season. Let's go. Like I said, the graphics are, they're a big, big difference compared to the last game in 2015. It was, was it? This is a lovely little lady.
I'm Emma Jenkins. I'm a specialist in contract law.
And Emma Jenkins. Well, hello, Emma.
I'll be working to get you the,
she's a bit of a darling for a computer character, isn't she? Job out there on the circuit.
When you get new contract offers, either from new teams or an amendment to your existing offer, it'll come through me. Discussions behind the scenes to change your terms or any specific goals that the team has set for you. If a contract offer does come through, I'll present to you the available offers and then you can make the call. I assume that all sounds fine. Well then, good luck this season and I'll catch you later.
Oh, she's got a set of pins on her, hasn't she? Lovely set of pins. Welcome to Manor Basin MRT. We are delighted to have you on board. I look forward to working closely with you over the upcoming season. You will start as our second driver alongside your teammate Pascal Wehrlein. We expect you to work together to help develop the car and the team as quickly as possible. Now let's get out there and win some points. Kind regards, team management. Okay, so we go into the laptop. What have they got for us? Laptop introduction. Within the laptop, you can manage your career whilst off the track when you are ready. Head to the team garage and start your first practice session. Brill. Well, let's go, guys.
Welcome to Melbourne, where the practice session is about to start for this weekend's Australian.
See the graphics. I just think that's amazing. The waters look so real. It's great. I think it'd be better if they had
a lot of focus,
the public, the fans, a better viewing for them.
Everything right as well. As one little mistake could cost the team and one of their drivers the race.
The graphics, I think, are amazing. Compared to 15 was. This was a bit bland. It was just nothing really to it. This one, there's like celebrations after they get up on the podium, which is great. The other one was just said you won, that was it. So this is it's quite a difference. But the career mode seems so good so far. So let's go. See what we can do. Seems quite a nippy little car from the off. Bit of understeer, but nothing too bad that you've got to worry about. But quite a bit of understeer, so we'll have to sort that out. Grass. So I don't think it's going to be a car that's going to be able to compete with the likes of Hamilton and Mercedes, etc. I think it's going to be in the maybe in the top 10. But I don't think this car has got the performance and the steering to match up to the giants at the top. A bit understeer. Quite a bit of understeer with this car. Well, I don't want to do a career mode with a Mercedes or a Ferrari. I want to try and work up to deserve the contract offers. But they've upgraded the game so much with, as I say, with the celebrations and everything else, talking to your agent and that kind of stuff. They've really excelled themselves with this game at the moment. Really happy with it. Graphics are amazing. I just think the people look so real. Toto Wolff from Mercedes looks identical like he does in real life. It's insane. That's a great game. So I would advise to get it if you can. Maybe ask Santa for it for Christmas. Oh, that understeer, I've got to sort that out. Yes, it is, Jeffrey. Car's giving me a lot of trouble out here. Understeer to shit. Yeah, it hasn't got the performance power to keep up. I mean, look, Alonso. I'm down to third. I was first. It's just hasn't got that pulling power like the Mercedes, and I don't think it's going to struggle with McLaren. McLaren Honda, I don't think it's going to struggle with them because the Honda engine isn't fast. So. Just needs a tweak, I saw. Understeer a little bit. Hasn't got a good steering column like the Mercedes or the Red Bull. So we go to the pits. I don't know if we can change the steering from the pits or if you've got to do that in the menu. But yeah, it's hella understeer. Really bad. So we'll take a look at the car. We'll see what we can do with the steering. Come on in, guys. All right. Right, set up. You can check the details in the car monitor. Can I do anything with teams, so well worth running. Right, set up car settings. I need somebody to help me with cornering, so that will be balance man. Stability with reduced cornering stability. This set makes the car harder to control. No, don't need that, it's already hard enough to control as it is. With a further reduction in downforce, the car is extremely difficult to control through corners. No, the balance provides with you good performance, giving you balance, cover, and ability to speed. If you're struggling to make it through corners, this setup will provide you with good stability when under braking and according. But give you lower top speed. So you've always got to sacrifice something, haven't you? Well, let's go with that and let's just see how much top speed it does lose. Front wing aerodynamic. Let's put it there. Bit of both on 8. Transmission, suspension. Fuel, this is weight distribution, tires are fine, brakes are good, suspension's okay, suspension, transmission, aerodynamic, right, safe. Right. Let's try that. See if that helps around the corners any better than it was. DRS enabled. DRS, wow, I've gone up to 11th. This is going to be difficult in this car. Maybe I should have shown Sauber, I've got a bit of a faster engine, but just thought I'd try and challenge myself. At least if I get a, I can get a deal with a big team, I've earned my spot. You know, I've earned the right to be there rather than just like a big team from the off. It's a little bit better. Look, the steering's a little bit better from the aerodynamics, from the downforce, but yeah, if you haven't got this game, and please get it, it's great. Don't hesitate to add me for racing. Clean racing, I like clean racing. That's better. Going through that chicane, like, real smooth now. It was a little bit understeerish at the beginning. It may have just been me late on the brakes, but felt like it was understeer quite a lot in this manor racing car. How's that time? Any better? Well, one place. Let's try and get a better time than that. I'd like to get in the top 10 if I can. I'm not expecting too much out of this car. You know, I think it's the lowest team in the F1 at the moment, so I'm not expecting anything. Can't blame the car. It's not, you know, or the driver, it's just the team. The team's not, it's not a great team, not a lot of money, so the car is not as quick as the bigger teams, but Mercedes is definitely the best car on there. So fast, great at handling, deals with downforce exceptionally well, steering's great. It's a really great car. The McLaren is, well, like it is in real life, is shocking. It really is shocking. The Red Bull is great on here. Real good car as well. And the Ferrari. Well, Ferrari's okay, actually. I say that, it's okay. It's just the steering, again, it's a bit of understeer. No, I didn't move a spot, I kept the same spot. That's a shame. Close. If I'd have hit that grass, my ass would have been grass. Some great straights, long, fast parts of the circuit on the Australian Grand Prix. It's one of the best circuits by far. The British Grand Prix, it's really quite difficult at high speeds. It's the first track, Silverstone, but it's very narrow. It's quite hard for overtakes, apart from a couple of corners, it's quite wide corners. So obviously it gives you a chance to come in on the inside, swoop in and take a position like that. But other times, it's hard to overtake at Silverstone. But this is one of my favourite tracks. Australian, Hungarian Grand Prix, never a good one. Mexico, it's a good track. So there's some great tracks on here. Daniel Kvyat, I've got no chance of keeping up with him. I'm in a manner. Whoa! Oh, fucking hell! Fancy that! Bloody hell! Well, there's no point in rushing now, is there? I'm bloody gonna Not going to beat my time now. It's only practice, but it's... You want to try and get as fast a laps down in practice as you possibly can, because then when it comes to qualifying, you're warm, you're ready. Because in a car like this, if I was in a Mercedes or a Red Bull, I wouldn't really be worried about qualifying, because you know in a car like that, you're going to get through the pack really well. But this car, you need a good qualifying time, really, to try and compete with the front runners. Otherwise, you're always going to be at the back. If you start from 22nd in this car, you're probably going to finish in 22nd in this car. But saying that, it's not as slow as I thought it would be. I chose this car thinking it was going to be, you know, pile of crap, but it's actually pleasantly surprising that it's not. So, what am I now? Still not going to be the same, and I'm not going to move anywhere. No. Okay, return to the garage. But I would suggest to get the game. It's a great game. And they've come so far from the last year's one. 2015 was, it was an alright game, but graphics were nowhere near as good as this one. So when you feel you've got used to the track, you want to just skip through practice. Just R2, it just skips you straight through it. Let's advance, and then go to practice 2, skip through that. Practice 3, skip through. One shot qualifying, unless you choose more qualifying than that. One shot qualified I do, and then I go straight into the race. So, go through here. You just press that as well, you can skip that.
Hi. Good to meet you at last. My name's Chris, and I'll be working with you as your chief of vehicle development.
So the graphics are amazing. You know, I think he looks so real. It's insane for a computer game. In the areas that you feel are most
lacking. At each Grand Prix, we can run a series of practice programs and log the performance of the car as you drive it at its limit. This gives us data that we can utilize to develop various performance improvements.
In order for I'll need you to select a development. Some lengths on this one.
And you can do that in the R&D section of your laptop. Anyway, that's all for now. But I'll keep you up to date, okay? I'll see you soon.
See ya. Bye. Right, laptop. So, ignition power. You can go there, purchase that. And then, basically, you earn racing points. So, with the points you earn, you can upgrade your engine. Then you can go down here, sort out your fuel efficiency, chassis weight, your downforce, front wings, drag, etc., etc., etc. Your drag reduction system, which obviously your DRS, you can manage all of that from here. And then obviously your leaderboards. It's great. Right, so you go to session 2, and then I skip through that usually when I'm used to the track, which I am. So we'll skip through this, guys, and then we'll be on practice 3. I'll skip through that. I'll be straight into one-shot qualifying. Hopefully get a good qualifying time. And then it's race day. Moment of truth. But I'm sort of my games room in that back out within the next few days. So I will be making my videos on camera, so you will see me doing the commentary with the game properly, it'd be a bit more fun rather than just seeing my avatar and just hearing my voice. I'm actually going to be doing it all properly, have a mic set up and, you know, camera set up. It's all going to be done properly again. I just haven't had time to clear out, etc. So as soon as I've done that, guys, is there this these videos just for your viewing. If you've got the game, it just helps you just see what you can, you know, give you that little bit of knowledge about the game before you maybe get it or whatever. Because I know for sure before I got the game, I wanted to watch YouTube videos and I wanted to watch what the game was like. I wanted to see the graphics, I wanted to see the tracks, and before I went and bought it, I watched YouTube videos. It really helped me get a feel for the game before I bought it, so I knew I liked the game before I got it. So this is all this video on YouTube is for. This is what I'm doing it for, just for guys who are interested or girls are interested in buying the game. You get a little feel for it beforehand. So I hope it helps. But I will be live streaming properly with camera within the next few days while I'm back in my games room. At the moment I'm just in my bedroom. I got a day off work, it's been rained off, so I look a mess. So I'm not on camera today. It's just a video for, like I say, for you guys to watch. So yeah, you skip through. It runs by quite fast. I did try and get practice one, just get one or two practices, so I didn't have to sit around and forward through practice like I am now on every race. But unfortunately, you can't do that. You've got to have three practice sessions. So I find after the first practice session, I'm used to the track. My times are good, so I skip the other two practice sessions and then I go straight to qualifying. But practice sessions are good, so don't skip through all three of them, because you want at least one to test out different tyres. So you'll have a pair of super soft, pair of softs, and then what you'll do is you'll test both those tyres out on the track to see which times are faster. So she's quite fit for a computer character, isn't she? She's a bit of a sort. Oh, so my teammate's a challenger, is he? Right. So he was ninth. I was 11th, I believe. Right, so listen to voicemail.
Hi, it's Emma. Your qualifying goals came up in the board meeting this morning. Here's what to expect.
Why did she just tell me that when she was just stood there? Doesn't make sense, does it? So you go back into your laptop then, guys, and then you go to one-shot qualifying. This is when it really counts. You've got to try and get a good time, especially in the car I'm in, because like I said, I've started a career with Manor, and they're not the fastest of cars. They're never going to compete with the Red Bulls and the Mercedes and the Ferraris. It's just no way. I think the biggest name they're going to compete with are McLaren, Honda, and Force India. Even McLaren Honda, when they drop Honda, McLaren are one of the best teams in the world, probably the number one team. They have been for many years, but at the moment, with Honda, they're terrible. So you skip through this, guys. Then, basically, the team are offering me super softs. They're saying basically that's what they believe is going to be the fastest tire, going from other people's lap times. But if you still want to choose softs, you can. So, but like it says there, lap time 0.648 seconds. That's on a soft. That's why it's red, because it's showing not a very fast lap time. You go to this one, no lap times have been set, so they're saying choose that one because you're probably going to get a faster lap time. So here we go. Wish me luck, guys. Let's do it. DRS is enabled. Braking. Understeer's gone a bit, but it's still there. Hamilton, obviously. We all knew Hamilton was going to be right out there anyway. Not just in real life, but on the computer, he's absolutely amazing. So he's not going to be worried about me. I'm not going to contend with him for the lead, because like I say, I'm in a Manor racing car. It's never going to compete with the power of that Mercedes, unfortunately. But the goal is to race through and hopefully at some point get offered a contract by Force India, someone bigger. I'm all over the track here because I'm talking, I'm looking, and I'm doing everything but what I should be doing. But yeah, the game is so real to life. Like, Lewis Hamilton's really good on here, so is Rosberg. All the top drivers are really good. And I find the leaderboard is always the same people. Hamilton, Rosberg, Ricciardo, Max Verstappen, Bottas. They're all always like first, second, third, fourth, fifth. It's always the same people out there. Like it is in real life. In real life is usually Hamilton, Rosberg, Bottas. And that's what it is with the game as well. Max Verstappen, they're all on air. I've got a terrible qualifying time. Can't believe I just messed that up. So 14th, 15th, Matt. Where did I come? Oh, I'm last! I can never be last. That is not true. Well, I am absolutely baffled by that. That must have been when I went off the track. So, see, the difficulty, you've got very easy, easy, medium, hard. But I don't feel I'm very good for like hard yet. So I've gone to medium, and even medium is really difficult to win. It is quite difficult. So, right, okay. Moving on. Oh, what? What, just because I come fucking last in qualifying? Give me a chance. So we go to race now, guys. Oh, fucking typical, wasn't it? It's got to be raining. Great. Bloody hell, I was struggling in the dry. Right, okay, guys, so... Australian Grand Prix, in the rain. Fantastic. Yeah, of course they are. They're going to be in our... Two Mercedes, two Ferraris. Two Red Bulls, see what I mean? It's just like real life. They literally did put it in the teams. So they've obviously set it up like that, but... Oh my God, it's raining. Oh, I hate the rain. I'm no good in the rain. Right. I'm going to go for two stops in the rain because the tyres are probably going to not hold out very well. Can I get my way then? Oh, what's wrong with people? So this is the formation lap, guys. What the hell was going on then? What the hell? I do not get this. Information. It's really cool as well, guys. You can hold in L1 and talk to your team just like they do in real life. You can ask them questions and stuff. Information. Engineer. Well, you usually can. I don't know what's going on. Engineer. What What the hell is going on? They didn't even let me do my full reforming grid for restart. They didn't even let me do my formation lap. So all the other cars have got their tires warm, and I'm literally the one, Jolly and Palmer, but I'm the, us two, that's not been able to warm our tires up. Here's the other lot, here's Lewis. But now, I'm going to warm my tires up then. That's terrible. So they're all reforming now, getting ready for the race. I am in 22nd, that is absolutely terrible. I really thought I didn't, obviously I come off the track, but I thought my qualifying time would be better than that. That's a little bit disappointing, to say the least. Hülkenberg, Romain Grosjean, Carlos Sainz, they're all coming now. Gutierrez, Daniel Kvyat, Wehrlein, that's my teammate, Magnussen, Ericsson, and Felipe Nasri. Right, we're ready. Right, so there's a right hand turn in the first corner, so I'm going to have to try and stick in tight without hitting the wall. Wish me luck, guys. Let's do it. Getting caught up here. Well, I can't see anything. Whoa, someone's at the back of me. Come on, guys, be fair, like, stop playing dirty. Oh, I couldn't see nothing. Better not punish me for that, because I couldn't even, it's not even my fault, I couldn't see anything. Oh, behave. So I've got to use a flashback on that, because that is insane. Come on, what are you doing? Dirty bastards, even the computer are fucking dirty players. Oh, come on. What's wrong with you bastards? Oh, my front wing's gone. Yeah, my front wing's gone. Shit.
Okay, copy that.
No, my front wing's gone. Fucking hell! Well, because these dirty bastards, like, can't race fair. Bloody computer as well. It's not even like his real fucking people. Understand it then. Look! Just click, look! Fucking dirty cunts! Oh, what a joke! Little Wattams. And my front wing's damaged, I'm gonna have to pit. Minor damage, take him, drive. Oh my days! Are you fucking serious or what? Unbelievable! As a computer player, am I doing that? How many flashbacks I've used? My points are going to be absolutely terrible. Look again! Grosjean, you fucking French prick! Learn how to drive! Unbelievable! Can you believe? Can you add me that one? Look, my front wing's gone. I've got no steering at all. Fuck off, Alan. Winning Abu Dhabi on a weekend, don't talk to me, mug. Look at that, that is terrible. Box.
Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap.
Unbelievable. What a joke. To take the piss, I'm all the way down there. Insane. Should never have picked this car. This car is terrible. I should have picked a Sauber, but it's too late now. Let's get some heat into those tires. Should have got a Sauber. A bit more reliable, but try and get some heat in the tires. Have to brake hard next few corners. Yeah, it's understeer in this car anyway, but when you got wet tire, like cold tires, and you're being hit about by all these idiots, car's even worse. Braking hard. 21st, I can't believe that. I fucking hate the rain as well. I swear I picked clear in the settings. No good in the rain at all. Well, I am, but certain tracks, this track's just too much. So anyway, yeah, the game is great when it's not going like this. Like, this, it gets a bit disappointing when it ends up being like this, because you feel like you're being robbed a bit. Like, the computer, the drivers and the computer aren't usually as violent as that. They're a little bit reckless. Yeah, understeer. Understeer, oversteer, and it comes in. I'll have to get some RDA points and upgrade the car. Oh, that might help me. Positive to avoid a penalty. Slow down, maintain positive delta. Okay, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. If I go any fucking slower, I'll be parking, you prick. What an idiot. Oh, no way. How the hell have I got a drive? What, are you taking the fucking piss or what? How the hell can you give me a drive-through penalty? I was going slow. If I'd have gone any slower, I would have stopped. Oh my god. How fast have I got to go then? Just tells you to keep your speed low. Don't tell you what fucking speed. Unbelievable. Disqualified me. Are you fucking serious? Don't tell... Keep your speed low. Doesn't tell you what fucking speed. Ugh. Whatever. Full of shit. That is unbelievable. Unfucking believable. Keep your speed down. I should say keep your speed below fucking 60 or whatever. Unreal. Unbelievable. Yeah, skip. Let's get on with it. Next race. That'll probably be in fucking snow. No, my luck. What a cunt. Right, well, Sorry about that, people, with the swearing and that, and viewer's discretion, over 18s if possible. But bloody hell, like, what a joke. That was terrible. Apologies, that wasn't very good racing.
I've got something for you. The new parts have been fitted to the car. The simulation numbers are good, so look forward to your feedback. Check out the details.
Yeah, I will. Cheers, Jeffrey. Bye then. An extra eight brake horsepower. Oh, Dordy Cacker, thanks very much. So kind of you. Extra 800 would have been nice. Might have been able to keep up with the, you know, Mercedes. Now this track, what an absolute beaut of a track. So nice. Very windy, very bendy, very technical. And yeah, it's real good. If you can race this track well, you can race anything. Here we go, Bahrain, practice one. Right, let's try and do better than I did last time, eh? Thing is, you know with this track, it's not going to be raining. When is it raining in the desert? But no my luck, it probably will be bloody raining. Never know rain in the desert until Dodge gets there. So fast. This straight. And this corner is so tight. When you get rain, lovely track to drive, just not in this car. The way things are going so far, I don't think I'm going to get a big contract offer from one of the giants. Maybe I might get a Sauber or a Force India at a push, I reckon. Just can't compete with the top drivers on there, not in this car. It's just no power. It's not a slow car, it just isn't as fast as these, mind you. The Haas that Grosjean's in, that's not a great car. It's not a really fast car. Shit, why is it sometimes they're like ghost frames, so you drive straight through them, and other times they're like that, and it's got to be the time I crash into them, they got to be like that. What a joke. They crash into me and they're ghosts. It's like, come on, be fair. Yeah, this track, awesome. Awesome track. This straight, you're clocking over 200 miles an hour. Look, 207 miles an hour. Wow, imagine doing that speed. Be amazing. Love to drive one of these cars in real life. Just for like, just 10 minutes, just a few laps. Did it say I had the fastest lap then? That's great. Mind you, Lewis Hamilton ain't that yet, I didn't think. Be a different story when that Mercedes engine comes out to play. It's game over. I usually do quite well in Bahrain now. I like Bahrain. Yeah, look, Alonso's second, so I'm not going to keep that spot for long. Alonso second. Losing third, I can't see. I don't want to look because I want to concentrate. So when you come to a corner like that, you want to tap brake instead of just hit it hard, otherwise you just slide off. Yeah, so Grosjean's third, yeah. like to get in the at least the top 15 this time. Just this car, it's just not enough power. Even with DRS, you're only just reaching 200 miles an hour. Where the Mercedes, by the time you get here, they're clocking about 220. It's just so much difference in speed. Good thing about this game is you don't get hackers, you know, like you do on other games. Like I play Rainbow Six Siege, and it's just hackers. PC players are just hacking into the game, and it's annoying. So I turned to Formula One for a bit. I'm better at Formula One as well. There's my teammate. Here's my teammate. He's in fourth. But the big guns ain't came out to play yet. When the big guns come out, you'll be able to tell if your time's any good or not. Look at the surroundings, you know, like the mountains in the background. The graphics are so good. The Bahrain Desert. I'd like to go and watch this in real life, the Bahrain Grand Prix. I think it'd be lovely. Lovely weather, car racing, podium chicks. What's better than that? Right, let's see if my DRS can get him. Give it a slipstream. Oh, literally broke so late then. Just wanted to get past my teammate. Want to outdo him, not the other way around. So now you see the Renault coming out then. I think that was Magnussen. So you got the Renaults coming out, so gradually the bigger cars are coming out to play. So I might think I'm doing well at the moment as soon as those cars come out. It's good night, Irene. As you get to a corner, just tap, 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 tap. Some people slam the brakes straight on and it just doesn't do you any favours. So I'm going to turn. DRS. Try and remember DRS, sometimes at the bottom of the screen, but you hear a little noise. Ding! And that's a DRS bar coming up. Always remember that. As soon as that comes up, press triangle. DRS is enabled. When you're out, it automatically turns off. You ain't got to worry about pressing it again and getting in trouble. It takes off itself, so it's good like that. Unless you're doing like legendary racing, then you got to do everything yourself. It's really hard. So, still showing I'm in first. That's made me happy. How long can I keep that spot? That's the only problem. I know there's only practice. Qualifying's not yet, but how long can I keep this spot? Sometimes it feels like it's oversteer, other times it's understeer. It's weird, it's really weird. I've never had this problem with a car before. Apart from a Ferrari, I've driven a Ferrari and it felt like it was so much understeer for what car it was. You'd think it'd be these cars with the problems, not the big cars, but there's such a problem with it. DRS. Yeah, it does make such a difference to DRS in the top speed, so when you got this, when you're on this game and you're racing, always remember DRS sections. But as you race different tracks, you'll become knowledgeable, you know where the DRS sections are. It's usually always on the big long straight sections. But you never have DRS here, for instance, because it's not enough of a straight to have it on. So you wait till you get round here. And now you'll get it. So over this line, DRS, triangle, top speed, what's it, miles per hour? 198, 199, 204, 208, 208 miles an hour. Gutierrez now, Grosjean's teammate. He's come out to play. Taking him. Right, as soon as I get around to the checkered flag, I'm going to go back to the garage. I'm going to keep the mediums on here because the mediums have done alright. They might choose me softs for the race because they're a better choice of tyre, but we'll see. So I'm going to finish this bit, go back to the garage and go to qualifying, and hopefully I can set a good pace qualifying. I can get out of there with the top runners. That'd be nice. Whoa. Bloody hell happened there? That was a bit shocking. Box.
Pitting this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap.
It's great. You can just talk to your team. It's amazing. Ask them anything. Leader. Go in pits. And if you don't want to wait and watch them carrying your car in and out and doing all that sort of stuff, what they do, they push it around and they'll take it in for you. But if you don't want to wait for all that, you can just go here, manage session, return to garage, just get you straight in there. So we've set. Oh, sets back. Fucking hell. Never mind. Right. Let's go into session. Obviously, we put a great lap time down. Skip practice. One. Does work quite fast. Gone down from 15 minutes to 1 minute, and then literally as soon as it's 1 minute, bang, it's done. So it's
an interesting practice session works there then.
Wow.
Let's remind ourselves,
I stayed top.
Who are Amana, Hamilton,
by quite a distance.
That concludes an interesting practice session.
Nearly a whole second. I am happy with that. Wow. I could possibly win this race in a bloody Manor racing car. Now that would be good. If I could do that, that'd be amazing. Like I say, skip all this. I usually skip through, press laptop. Now I should be matching. I should be hopefully matching my beating my rival by the time this session, this qualifying and race is done. Like I said, go straight in there now. Skip the practice. Thank you. So it takes you through all this. Qualifying is nearly up. Practice is nearly up. So you skip through.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are Hamilton, Rosberg, and Felipe Massa. Thank you for joining us for free practice today. We'll be back with more Formula One action very shortly.
So now that's over, we advance. Obviously, I wasn't on the leaderboard then because I didn't set a time. Now, sometimes loading can be quite slow, and other times loading can be fast, which is really weird because it's not online, it's just I'm just playing career. Multiplayer, depending obviously on your connection at home, your Wi-Fi, it should be quite quick. Mine usually is quite quick. Right, so I've done my fuel efficiency. I've paid for that. I'm going to go now to practice free. I'm going to go straight in and I'm going to skip again. Skip straight to qualifying. Like I said, it doesn't take too long. It takes a matter of real time, is probably a minute. Just skip through all of this. Doesn't take long at all. So if you're impatient like me, you just want to skip through things and you want to get to the nitty gritty, you want to get to the racing.
At the end of the session, then, here are your top three: Hamilton, Raikkonen, and Daniel Ricciardo. That's it for practice, then. We'll see you again soon.
Okay, so here we are, ready for qualifying. Now, there's no Q1, Q2, all that. There is one shot. You've literally got one shot at this. And then, my guys and girls, it is game over. So, here we go. Listen to your voicemail.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very well.
Qualifying goals for this weekend.
Qualify 90 for hire, beat Pasco Airline, right. Go to laptop. And we go straight to one shot qualifying. So I've upgraded my fuel efficiency and my engine performance, so the car should be running a bit better than it has been.
Qualifying is about to begin here in Bahrain.
Bahrain Grand Prix, it's not raining, like I said, because it's desert, so I should hope it isn't. Like I say, no, my luck, it's raining right when you don't need it to rain. You don't want it to rain, always rains. You want it to rain, it's not a bit there. Okay, guys, so the team have suggested I wear super softs. I'm gonna go with what they chose. So now it's qualifying, one shot. Right, let's do it. Let's go. Wish me luck. Let's do it. Let's get over. Practice, I was first, fastest time. Let's see if I can get the fastest qualifying time. That would be great. Mind you, my tyres are a bit cold. I haven't warmed them up. I got straight into it, but let's do it. Wow, the fuel efficiency that I bought and the engine performance is really paying off. It is helping, I can feel it. The car's running so much better. Yep. Any of you guys got this game, you have me. Clean racing only. Oh, blimey. Brilliant. DRS. Let's try and get our speed up. Wow, if I can get pole in a manner of racing against all these Mercedes and Red Bulls, that'd be amazing. I'd be well happy with that. I'd be happy with third. But if I can get pole, that'd be great. I got fastest time in practice. This is one shot qualifying, so you literally have one shot to do good. If you crash or you have a blowout or anything like that. Because this game now they've set it, you can randomly have a blowout as well. You can hit debris, etc. And you can have a blowout. What position am I? Fingers crossed. Yes! Yes! I've done it, guys. First place.
The grid is all set then.
Wow. I cannot believe I'm in front of the Mercedes in a manor race at an MRT. Wow. Right. I'm excited for race day. I know the Mercedes cars are going to literally pass me on the first corner, but I didn't care. I outdone them in qualifying. That's what matters. Wow. I was not expecting that. I was expecting that position to come back like 14th or 10th or something like that. But I'm well happy with that. That's fantastic. Hopefully I can beat my teammate. Oh, not far off. Not far off of him. I'm chasing him, catching him back up. My team expectations. Am I going to be above expectations? Or am I going to be... Oh, I'm still black. I got to win this race, aren't I, to get her faith back in me. Come on. Yeah, it's you. Hossie. Take care. Bye. Right, here we go, guys. It's race day. Go on my laptop. Send me to Bahrain. Here we go. Here we go. Let's have it.
After an exciting qualifying session yesterday,
it was very exciting, you're right.
It's Manor in pole
position. There's Mila. Oh, first. That actually looks very similar to me as well. That's a good avatar Vettel, for me. Kimi Raikkonen. Come on, guys. Whoa, should I have a one stop or two stop? Tires wear so easy, don't they? So laps, 14 laps. So I lap in. What lap do I lap? Do I pit? Fuel load. I'm gonna take a bit more fuel. That'll do. High tire management. I'm gonna go one stop. I could always pit again if I want to. Right. Oh, here we go, guys.
Right, let's get the car up to Tokyo on this lap.
Formation lap.
So go through them all if you can.
Formation lap, wave at the crowd. What? Rosberg crashed into me? What the fuck? Oh, don't say. Are you serious? Oh my god, I got removed from formation because he crashed into me. But he got to finish his form. Oh god. Yeah, some of it's unfair, guys, in this game. Look, oh no, he didn't finish his. He got sent as well. Okay. I was about to get pissed then. It's game on. It is race on. Oh, fuck off. I hate when Moist Telly does that. I do have to change the settings. Come on, guys, I want to race. Just see his nose there, look, ready to get me. I just got him to worry about either. I've got Lewis. Great. Look at the camera going along the top, look. Yeah, it's great, great graphics. There he is, look. World champion coming to get me. Come on. Come on, Dodge. See his little white helmet. His little air popping out. Come on, Dodge. You can do it. Let's go. Never gonna have enough power to beat these Mercedes. Look at that, they're coming right up by me. I've got no chance. All I can do is brake late. Whoa! I did it, guys. I'm out in front. Managed to get that spot. Rosberg's right there. Rosberg is right there. Rosberg is right there. I'm going to have Hamlin on me in a minute. Hamlin's blatantly going to take Rosberg at some point. And I'm going to have him all over me like a rash. Well, I'm pulling away a little bit. I just need to try and get a good distance while they're fighting. I need to take advantage of that. I'm never going to pull away that much because this power of this engine isn't nowhere near the power of, like I keep saying, the bigger cars. But I will do what I can. I will try and pull away as best I can. So you make a mistake, they're right there. They're right on you. Needs to get a good lead out for when I got a pit. I want to try and have a good distance between me and them so I can get out in front and not have to worry about them taking me. Just gotta look after my tires as well. Don't break like real hard. Well, I should be at a DRS zone to Rosberg, to be fair. Yeah, I think I am. I'm at a DRS zone to Rosberg, that's good. I don't want to be in Rosberg's clutches. I don't want him to be on me. I want to try and get away from Rosberg and Hamilton. I want to try and get a good lead, and then when I got a pit, they're not going to be able to beat me in the pits. It's the last thing I want, race hard and then get beat in the pits. That'd be horrible.
We think there's a viable strategy change available to us. Would you like to keep to the current plan or try the new one?
Just got to look after my tyres. I'll take the new plan, why not? Teams usually know best, don't they? So I'll take his plan. Teammate.
Okay, distance to teammate, 20.7 seconds. They're on old super softs. The time last lap was a 45.9.
Thanks. I think that's so cool as you get to talk to your engineer like that. That's brilliant. You could do that on 15, they've come a long way on this game. Brilliant. I can't believe this car is actually out in front. It's unbelievable. By some distance as well at the moment. Rosberg chasing me down, but so far so good. I'm out of his DRS soon, so that goes in my favour, so he can't take me on DRS. Right, I'm pitting. Come on, team. Come on, team. Come on. I've got to try and catch back up now and hope I can catch Rosberg before he gets in those pits and back out again. Gutierrez should be on old tyres, so I should be able to get past him. Right. Past him. put some heat in these tyres. Brake late a few times, come on. Take advantage while they're fighting back there. Gotta try and get back and get round before Rosberg can pit and get back out. Don't want him taking my spot. Or Lewis. His career mode is brilliant. Absolutely fantastic. I'd definitely recommend getting the game if people haven't already. But great experience. Leader.
The difference is 5.8 seconds. They're on old super softs.
Oh, so you haven't pitted yet? Oh, they only got one stop. I got another stop, and I know I haven't got one stop as well. Oh, so I got to look after these tyres. Sorry, Jensen, I love you, but I gotta go. Come on. I know he is, he got my spot. He hasn't pitted yet, he got one more lap. He's pitted now, isn't he? Is that him? No, it's Massa. Max Verstappen, I don't think he's pitted yet. No, he couldn't have pitted, because he would be in front of me.
Pascal is coming to the pits. Pascal in the pits now.
Okay. So my teammate's pitting. Should I pit as well? Just take the piss. Oh! Brilliant! That was a blessing. I should take him anyway, because I was first before I went in the pits. And he's and gone in the pits. But he got a problem with his car, that's great for me. Oh yeah, I am back in first. So look after my tyres. So six laps left. Come on. Go on, dodgy boy. Get right there. This would be a great win. And an MRT. Man of racing, I am first. That is what you see every day, is it?
That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
Thank you. Get in there. Get in there. Come on. Let's do it. So close now. Just smell that checker flag from here. Rosberg.
Say that again, we're having trouble receiving.
Rosberg.
You are in first position, front of the pack.
I am white ass, dumb shit. Get in there, come on. That was a stroke of luck that Rosberg had car problems. Well, it wasn't, because I was racing better than him anyway, I was out in front, but it's just one less person you gotta worry about chasing you down. So I've only gotta worry about, well, Rosberg's still in third, so he's obviously not out of race. So I've got Raikkonen behind me. I don't know how far behind me, I haven't looked. My tires are starting to wear now. Oh, I'm quite a distance in front.
The gap behind us is 8.9
seconds. 8.9
seconds?
I'd probably be able to pit again if I really had to. I don't want to, but... with four laps left. I would like to pit again, but I might have to, because the tyres are wearing already. I'm looking after them, but...
Okay, some information on Rosberg. They're speeding up again, so I expect they fixed whatever the problem was.
Yeah, I knew they would. I'm looking after my tires doing that, am I? Bloody get off the curbs. You hit those curbs, you take big chunks out of your tires. Shows you tire images and stuff after the race, and you see your tires get chewed right up. Like that. What are you doing? Throw it away now. Yeah, sliding a bit now, tires are starting to really wear it now. Three more laps.
You're losing a small amount of time to the car behind. Keep pushing.
Yeah, because my tires are wearing, you thick twat. Of course I am. Of course you're going to lose some time when your tires wear. What sort of engineer are you? Not a very fucking smart one by the sounds of it. As long as I've got enough fuel, Don't worry about it, Jeffrey. I'll get to the end of the race. But Boykin is just turning that corner, let alone that one. Raikkonen's a fair distance away. He's saying he's catching up, but every time I turn a corner, he's in the same spot. And the fact of the matter is, I'm still so far in front, I could probably pit again if I really had to. So, engineer, you don't know what you're on about. See? It was 8 seconds just now, so how is he catching up? If anything, I'm getting further away from him. Melt. Come on, Dodgenator, let's do it. A Manor racing car out in front in a Grand Prix. What the shit? Looked after my tire as well. Might as well. Yeah, definitely looked after my tires because usually by now it's sliding all over the place. We're in a track. I still got decent-ish grip left. Look after my tires, alright. Get a podium finish from a Manor racing car, that's going to be an achievement. I've never won in a low, like lower budget car. I've always won in like Mercedes or Red Bulls. So to win this would be good. That'll get my team chatting, won't it? 5 laps of fuel remaining, I only need 2. That's the point I don't get with a game. What's the point in telling me something like that? There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. There's only 2 laps left. So what are you telling me that for? That's irrelevant. It doesn't matter. All that means is I can change my fuel to lean or whatever, or rich. That's all that means. One more lap. Well, 2 more laps. Manor Racing. Cannot believe it. Bloody hell. I'll be having bloody Ferrari knocking at my door in a minute, offering me a bloody job driving like this in a bloody manner.
Low chance of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know.
Oh, don't say that. Rain in a desert, mate. Only my luck, innit? Never rains in the desert. As soon as I'm winning, rains in the desert. Tires lasting well. Feeling good. Last lap.
Final lap of the race.
Come on, Dodge. How far back they are. I could probably pull over for a minute and have a drink. It's on medium level as well. It's not easy. So, I'm doing bloody well for an MRT car. For a Manor car. Definitely. I don't even get this far in front of the bloody Mercedes. It Just to get the office talking.
There's 4 laps of fuel remaining.
I need one, bruv. As long as I don't make any mistakes in these corners, we've done it, guys. We've done it. The start finish line for Rosberg and that to get out to me and then just crawl over. Yeah, tires are starting to go now, look, literally just in time. Nowhere to be seen, that. How about that?
Brilliant stuff from Manor today. What a superb victory. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed. It's all about maintaining.
Absolutely enjoyed that.
Consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
And I can see our drivers making their way out now. It's been an incredible performance and the culmination of a huge
amount of effort. Manor Racing in front.
Are your winners today?
Not every day you see that.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a good result for Nico Rosberg, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I think it's got to be Kimi Raikkonen. He's not always spectacular, but he quietly gets the job done. And that's the case today.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. It was also a standout performance from Manor Racing today. Great stuff from them to move up the standings. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take...
Chinese Grand Prix next. Right, okay. So, I'm fourth. 25 points. Could do better than that, I think. Can we do any more to my car? No. Not yet. Right then, next weekend it is. I'll do 5 laps on this one, just because the last 25% are done my fingers right in with that control pad. So I'll do one shot qualifying, start session. Yeah, why not? Start session. Oh, allocation. I'll go 5 and 4, 4. MRT race, manor racing team win in Bahrain. What a result that was. Unbelievable.
Hi, how are you today?
I'm right, sir.
We're having it fitted in time for FP1. Have a look at the factory report.
He's a Jeffrey. Everyone knows a Jeffrey. Everybody knows a Jeffrey. He is a Jeffrey. He's a bloody Jeff. He's a bloody Jeffrey. Right, let's go to practice one, China.
Good morning, and I hope you're as excited as
good morning to you. I'm very excited, thanks. Let's get out on track, guys. Let's go and test this China out. The RS, boom, straight in. Fast track, this is some fast corners. DRS enabled. For track a bit slightly. Understeer to shit. So much understeer on this manor racing team on these cars. That's one thing I'd like to sort out is the steering. I'll have to pay to have that done. But you were in, it's a bit like Call of Duty and Rainbow Six Siege, you earn like credits where you can spend on your car, which is good because obviously you want to update things to your car. Whoa, was that a wheel in the middle of the track then? It looked like it was going to hit me in the head. Right, so the Chinese Grand Prix, if I can get a good practice session in now, I will skip the rest of the practice and go straight ahead for the qualifying. If I can get myself in the top three of the fastest laps, then I'll skip straight to qualifying. It's only a 5-lap race this one. I'm not going to do another 25% yet because bloody hell, that is hard work on your fingers and your hands on that control pad. How people do 100% race? Oh my god, I couldn't do that, it's just too much. No, I'm in second. Understeer, Christ. Come on, beat Rosberg's time. Let's try and get pole. I won't get pole because it's not qualifying, but let's practice on getting pole. I reckon I could win this Grand Prix because I like the track. The track's good for overtaking, which is bad for me if I'm in the lead. But good for me if I see that tire still there. It's like it's in the middle of the track, it's in the air. It's obviously a glitch or whatever, but Christ, that was a bit lower. That smacked me straight in the head for like Felipe Massa. after this season, I'd like to try and get a contract with Mercedes or Red Bull or something like that, you know? So I'm going to try and get as many podium finishes in the manner of racing as I can. DRS.
That lap puts you in P2. P2 with that last lap.
Still in P2. You have a track. Fucking understeer. Come on. Should be turning way more than that. It's just not enough, man of racing. Come on, sort your car out. I'm never going to get a pole now because I come off the track. I've never known this game to pit Rosberg first all the time, or like near first. I've always known it to be Hamilton or Button or something like that. Rosberg's hardly ever been put up there. Which is good, because it's good to mix it up a little, and plus Rosberg is driving well at the moment. He is a good racer, he's just a sore loser. Sulks a lot. So even when he's in the wrong, like when he smashes Lewis Hamilton off the track, he then moans about it. He gets a penalty. Oh, sorry mate, but... he raced dirty. Got him. Hamilton's an aggressive racer, but he's not a dirty racer. He's aggressive, he's late on the brakes. Well, I admire that. That's ballsy.
Oh, don't do that to me. Oh, bloody hell. Oh, sorry about this, people. I should have put my controller on charge. Darn it. Not so panicked there, my lead's right there. It's not the end of the world, as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it.
Right. There we go, we're back. Minor glitch. Right, choose this lap to try and get P1. If I can beat his time. I can beat Rosberg's time in practice, then I'll just skip all the rest of the practice in. Go straight for qualifying. Try and get P1. DRS. Still ain't got a better position than that. one, two, and fourth. Bottas. Bottas. There's Bottas third. Leaves me fourth. So if I can at least get third from Bottas, I'll be happy with that. Then I can skip all the practice in, go straight in for the qualifying, and hope to beat him in that as well. And then be in the top three. But in a manner racing car, that's an achievement. I'm not expecting to win any more races after the Bahrain. I just won the Bahrain, and I'm happy with that. But if I win another one, well, winning races in a manner on a decent level as well, it's not like it's easy, so it's well chuffed for that. Starting to shine on this game, I think, a little bit. We're still fourth. No way. Understeer is crazy. Right, I'm happy with fourth. Return to Garrett. Skip practice. This will skip through. So you just skip through. Whenever you're done with practicing, you've tested your car, right? Just go into menu, R2, skip it all through like that. Practice 2, skip. Practice 3, skip. And then you got full qualifying. For some reason, it won't let you just have one practice session. It makes you have 3. But it does allow you to skip it. It just takes a while each time, that's all. Not too long, maybe about a minute real time.
Let's remind ourselves of the top three, who are Hamilton, Ricciardo, and Kimi Raikkonen.
Wow, I was 15th by the end of that.
Then, but no points are on offer just yet.
Well, we'll be back with Spurs was not last. But I thought I was flying, maybe. I suppose the manner racing cars just hasn't got the same power as the others. It's not going to compete with them. So skip, skip, skip. Open my laptop. Oh no, what are we doing? Leave me laptop. And then go, session. Practice session 2. Well, it's just raining, so you definitely don't want to do that. Skip through that as well. Happy days. So, practice is nearly skipped. Well, practice 2 anyway. Then we go straight into quali. One shot quali. I like to do one shot quali because it gets out of the way. Done and dusted. And if you've already had a bit of a practice, you don't really need a long quali. You just need a short quali. Straight into a race. Game on. Like I say, streams will be going on soon properly with me on camera. commentary, etc., proper mic. I'd be doing it all properly. I do appreciate people subscribing to my channel. I do appreciate people enjoying my videos. Oh, who said that? You know, I hope you enjoy the gameplay. I hope you enjoy my commentary. It's not that great, my commentary on here, unfortunately, because obviously it's racing, so you try and just, you know, concentrate, so you're not really talking much, but I do try. So bear with me.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three: Hamilton, Vettel and Max Verstappen. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for more excitement as the weekend unfolds. welcome you from wherever in the world you join us today for this F1 qualifying.
Keeping it there with Lewis at the moment, so I'm hoping my qualifying time isn't going to be too bad. I'm hoping I can get in the top three. I hope, please. Hamilton's going to obviously do me now on DRS because his car's just that much faster, but where is he? That was surprising. DRS. That's my lap time. Yes! Yes! I was not expecting first.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Amana, Hamilton, and Nico Rosberg. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
10th a second, literally. That's brilliant.
Hello. I just wanted to pass on the team's expectations for this race. Good luck.
Thank you. trying to save it to end the stream.
Since the salver of Felipe Massa passed Jenson Button into Turn 1 at the very first Chinese Grand Prix in 2004, Shanghai has consistently provided close racing and extraordinary memories. It's where Lewis Hamilton effectively lost the title in his rookie year, and it's where Nico Rosberg claimed Mercedes' first win of the modern era in 2012.
Good track.
Shanghai Internet. With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's Manor in pole position. So, another fantastic victory for Manor today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, I think the track conditions just really suited their car today. Wind, track temperature, you name it. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature. So the more easily you can keep them there, the better your race tends to go. And that's exactly what happened. Their car just looks so comfortable out there.
Here they are now. The drivers are on their way out after that spectacular race. You know, there's a lot of love for this team in the paddock and all over the world. What a victory here from Manor. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Sergio Perez. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. We saw a dip in form from the championship leaders today. Their lead has taken a significant blow. It was also a standout performance from Manor Racing today. Great stuff from them to move up the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
Me. I just came from a meeting with the department heads. Your performance came up and they're very pleased so far. Well done. Don't let that level drop, okay?
Hey, good to see you again. The factory sent over the
parts that were looking good on the rig. They're being fitted as we speak. Have a look at the report.
We are at the fascinating Sochi Autodrome in Russia for what is expected to be a compelling race weekend. But it all begins today with practice.